Good morning, dear children, and welcome to our English classes. From today onwards, we are starting the second term syllabus, and we are starting fifth chapter of our Honeydew book, that is The Summit Within. This chapter is written by H.P.S. Ahluwalia, and let me give you the introduction of this chapter. This chapter is about sharing the experience, feelings by author about the first Indian successful expedition to Mount Everest, where author was accompanied by or he was with the crew of some more members, and it was the first successful mission in year 1965. Major Ahluwalia and his team had conquered or had reached the top of world's highest peak, that is Mount Everest. Now, when he gives the experiences of how he was feeling when he reached at the top of the moon, let's see what is inside the chapter. Now, one of the emotion which came in his mind when he was at the top of world's highest mountain was the physical strength. His physical strength, or the physical of the author, said like he felt like, thank God, as he was already very tired by climbing the mountains for so many days. So the physical strength said or felt like, thank God, it's all over. Now we don't have to climb anymore. But along with this, there was a tinge of sadness. Tinge of sadness means there was a little bit of sadness in him, because he don't have to climb anymore now, because he has already reached at the top of world's highest mountain, that was Mount Everest, and all he had to do now was to go down back to his initial position, or to his initial point from where he started the journey of climbing or conquering world's highest peak. He says, all these memories, all these experiences gives you a lot of lifelong joy, which you enjoy for your whole life, which you tell everyone else, like you have achieved to climb the world's highest peak in very fierce condition or in very adverse conditions. It was a task. Climbing the mountain, Mount Everest, was like something which is very difficult for ordinary people, which everyone can't do, and he has already done something impossible, so it was like the world lifetime achievement. And then the first question, when all his tiredness will be gone after going down, after reaching to his original point, or after so many days of his journey, when all his tiredness will be gone, he will think, why people climb mountain? Why people generally go to mountains for climbing or expeditions like this? And the answer which came in the answers which come in his mind was, because people like to do adventurous things, people like to do difficult things, or which gives him fun and adventure both. People like when hard things came in their life, and when they overcome or cross over those hard things or hard times. So maybe because of this point or this reason, people climb mountains. And he says, rock climbing or mountain climbing, mountaineering is not a very easy job for everyone to do. It is a lifetime achievement which needs a lot of strength. But more than that strength, physical strength, it needs endurance. Endurance means your capability to deal with or to tolerate hard times or hard things. Your persistence, endurance, persistence. Persistence is your continuous efforts, your continuous continuity, and your strong willpower, your determination. So the three qualities which are required to be required for mountaineering or rock climbing or mountain climbing are endurance, persistence, and willpower or determination. With these, one can easily climb even the most difficult mountains in the world. Now, along with this, people like climbing mountain because of adventurous purpose, because they like to do difficult things, because they like obstacles and crossing over or overcoming them. There was another reason, personal reason for the author. And what was that personal reason? It was, since from his childhood, the author, Mr. Ahluwalia, was attracted towards mountain. He felt that mountains are the best creation of the world, of the nature. And he also felt these are a means of communion with the God. Communion means to relate yourself with the God. So mountains are also a means of communion with the God. So this was the personal reason why he wanted to climb mountains. And then the second question comes, why Mount Everest only? Why not other mountains or other peaks? Why people like to climb Mount Everest only? Then the answer to this came, because it is the highest peak in the world, because it is very difficult to climb Mount Everest, or because you cannot leave your rock climbing, mountain climbing, mountaineering expedition in midway. Once you have started off, you have to complete it anyhow, because if you want to go back or if you want to go down, even in that case also you will have to travel the same distance. So it's better people have, or the person has to complete his journey. And with this, when he was, it was a kind of big, because people Mount Everest only, because conquering Mount Everest or being at the top of Mount Everest is like winning a very huge battle, winning a lot of, means achieving something very big, which is impossible to achieve by ordinary people. And he says, when he was at the top of that mountain, when he was at the top of Mount Everest, he looked at his surrounding, to the more silvery peaks which were covered with the snow, and he liked, he felt how small he was in front of this nature's creation, how small he was in this beautiful world. He realized his smallness, and which was very difficult for him to avoid. Now, looking back, he explained himself that climbing mountain, answering the question why climbing Mount Everest only, was like answering personal questions, or which are very difficult to answer, like why do you want good neighbors, why do you want to breathe, why do you breathe, and these were the questions which were very difficult for a person to answer. Why do we breathe? Because we want to live, and if we will not breathe, we will die. So it was like, why Mount Everest? Answering this question was like answering one of the very difficult questions, like why do we breathe? And he says, there is no final answer, there is no certain answer for this question, why people climb Mount Everest only. Now, the physical conquest, your physical labor, your physical strength for achieving, conquering, for being at the top of world's highest peak, is not only the physical strength, but it takes a lot of emotional strength, because all the time you have to be very emotional, you have to be emotionally strong, you have to be emotionally set up, because many times things come like, oh, it is very difficult, let's give up the journey, let's go back. And you have to be spiritually very strong. You should have a firm faith in God. If a situation gets adverse, like the wind blows, you need to be spiritually very strong. Yes, this is the nature, it will pass on, it will go on. Be with it or keep trying, otherwise you will end up losing your journey, or you will end up going back to your original point, or from the point where you started. So climbing a mountain is not a very easy job. It is something which takes a lot of efforts. It takes your physical strength, your emotional strength, and your spiritual strength. You have to be very strong in all the aspects. And more than this, you need to show up the teamwork. And once you do things, with all these things, when you climb the mountain with all these qualities, with all these hopefulness, you feel a sense of fulfillment. You feel that your life or your purpose of the life is completed. You feel satisfied and you feel that you have achieved something which is impossible for ordinary people, and it gives you a lifelong pleasure. So class, up to this only I am explaining you today. What you have to do, you have to write down the new words in your pen or book in a very neat and clean handwriting, and leave one page after your last word, and on that page write down second term, and then start the work of fifth chapter in very beautiful handwriting. That's it for today class. I'll see you in our upcoming videos. Thank you and have a good day.